Dark winds rise around your locomotive as you stare towards the avid horizon, the gates slammed shut, cutting off the Neath and all of its deep, dark, and marvelous wonders. But there are still traces of that forgotten cavern here, the Z spilt into the sky, water and air dancing together, and further away from you, the flotilla, countless Z vessels lashed together on the Sky Z, like Khan's shadow, but perhaps less dangerous. You aren't sure you recall why you gave a gift of food, a sacrifice to this place. But it felt right. A tradition, perhaps, or perhaps pity on your part for the wretched souls shivering here, forgotten in the new empire. That's when you hear the footsteps, and turn to find yourself facing a tall, rake-thin figure, robed and hooded in dark fabrics almost as black as the sunless sea had once been. Yet as the figure moves closer, you feel at ease, comforted almost. They cough once to attract your attention. "May I?" they say, their voice masculine and strangely familiar. You nod, but hasten to ask,
"Who are you?"
The man lowers his hood. His features are strident, striking, made all the more so by the lattice of tattoos marking his face like a verdant birthmark. He extends his hands and says, "I am the Word made flesh, and you have fed ours. We would be glad, the Sepalisarians and I, to welcome you to our little enclave in the flotilla." He lowers his cloak to expose his tattooed collarbone. "But first you must read." You find yourself curious about this man and those who follow him, and so before you accept his offer, you ask him just who those who follow him are and what it is they believe. At your question, the illuminated archivist smiles blissfully. "We are those who were left behind, so we have decided that we chose to stay. We keep with tradition." He waves his hands airily about him. "Ours is a remarkably liberating lifestyle. You helped us, however indirectly, with your gift. I would like to return the favor." His words seem oddly comforting, familiar, as if they are being relayed to you in a comfortable room with a glass of broken giant 1844 at your side. Without even realizing it, you find yourself nodding, accepting this strange archivist's offer. You look closer at the ink marking his collarbone. The tattoos are a jumble of words and pictures. You make out a crab in a cave, a candle, and a roof. You recite the words you find there.
"I'm home."
He embraces you, his bony arms wrapped around your frame as if you were stumbling into a coffin. "Yes, you are home. Follow me, we are at the flotilla at the moment. I dislike the arrangement, but there are too few of us to survive alone. If you like, I shall teach you to read." He says read with a weighty, portentous inflection. Mist rolls in, grey as unwashed ghosts. Starlight washes in like a tide. You are known now to the mystics at the gate.